There has been an encouraging acceptance across the world that social protection provision should be seen as an investment in the economy rather than a wasteful welfare spending. In Uganda, social protection does not cut across all sectors of the economy. The informal sector is one of the sectors that players say has been neglected by relevant authorities, making it difficult for them to formalize. As a result, many have become victims of what they term as harsh laws, while others struggle once their businesses collapse since they don't have any form of saving.
Well, you cite an example of the KCCA. In 2006, they passed a law that hawkers and street vendors are supposed to be given permits so that they work. But since that time, today, up today, they have never been given a permit. But they are now, they are the very people who are bringing social protection of insurance, health insurance. How will they give health insurance when they don't recognize them?
Because of the lack of social protection in the informal economy, and maybe even the formal, you find that we are so much affected. And it's one thing that makes us so vulnerable to many things. Not vulnerable only in the way we are doing or lack of salary, but vulnerable that you find that putting our hands into other people's money, using it, you find corruption in Uganda all runs because of the lack of social protection.
Uganda's informal sector currently employs about 85% of the population compared to the formal sector that enjoys more social protection, yet it employs only 15%.
One should not see health insurance, health coverage as an expenditure, as a cost to the state, but rather as an investment. So if the Minister of Finance has to decide where to allocate public resources, whether it has to be allocated into road construction or into education or into defense, he or she should consider health coverage as a productive investment that maintains the productive capacity of the nation.
So if you are in the border, can we have some form of informal sector group where all those people will come together, their interests, their needs, and whatever strategies we need to develop which can work for them?
This was during a dialogue to discuss the need to extend social protection to workers in the informal sector in Uganda. Nelson Babiale, NBS, live at 9.